control.
Emotionally unstable, overly technical, patterned narcissist, shows off his strong jawline and eyelashes longer than 90% of the girls here. His lady friends are Danae Beyer and Keelan Kramer.
With deep brown eyes comes Alex Cheeseman. In his spare time, he's an undercover professional badminton player, and his man crush one day is Brian Bones. He is escorted by Ashley Morowski.
Here's Brian Betts, aka B Squared, as he struts his stuff with his round belly and his big brown eyes. His man crush Monday is Alex Cheeseman, and if he was a Disney princess, he would be Sleeping Beauty. He walks down with Keenan Foster.
With dreamy chocolate brown eyes comes Isaiah Patrick. Isaiah likes to coach toddlers in basketball, and if he could be a Disney princess, he would be Tiana from Princess of the Frog. Isaiah is escorted by Olivia Carter.
Next is Peyton Shepherd with his captivating smile that he claims to brighten people's day. If he was invisible for a day, he would cut in line, in every single line in Disneyland. His perfect date would be anything that has to do with food, and alongside him is Megan Bowie.
And here we have Jack's sister's boyfriend, Mitchell Weigel, with his beautiful body of a cross-country runner. His perfect headband is magical, and if he could be a Disney princess, he would be Tiana, because it's ironic, obviously.
Up next is all-star tennis player Ben Metzner with his striking green eyes and dirty blonde hair. His biggest pet peeve is red lipstick, and his favorite memory of Jackson was when he was voted most inspirational by his tennis team. He is accompanied by Sabrina Schoenwald.
And finally, we have, with vibrant green eyes and a firm right bicep, is Tyler Whitman. Tyler enjoys cooking, and his post-high school plans are to attend college and become a bodybuilder. He is escorted by the beautiful Amanda Crockett. Give it up for your contestants.
Daniel Higgins Sanchez. Keenan Foster. Zach Anders.
Alex Cheeseman.
Brian Betts.
Jackson, let's keep it real.
Yeah.
Today, we're going to be making a chocolate cake. Take it away, Tyler.
Thank you, Simran, and I'm going to be baking the perfect Mr. JHS cake for you all tonight. And here we have the finest tools and ingredients for baking this cake. And we're going to start with the freshest eggs in all of Mill Creek. As you can see. And we're going to beat the egg into the bowl. And then we're going to take our measuring cup. Yes, exactly, that measuring cup. We're going to take our flour and put it in with the egg. And put it all over my body, too. I'm trying. I'm a professional, guys. I'm trying to say. And then, of course, we're going to add the best part, the chocolate. And it should, yes, just all over the table. Thank you, hands. And we're going to take the measuring cup out of the cake mix. That, okay. And we're going to grab our little mixer. Exactly, that mixer. And we're going to mix vigorously. Really feel the passion. Just the way I like it. And we're finally gonna take our batter and drop it low.
Jackson High School, keep it classy here.
And then 350 degrees for 30 minutes, and you'll have the perfect Mr. JHS cake, everybody. Thank you.
Good afternoon, I'm Zach Anders. Here are tonight's top stories. A new study finds singles judge potential dates based on the quality of their teeth, followed by the quality of their grammar. Great news for whomever has both. Jackson student government elections are less than a month away. Early polling data indicates Hillary Clinton already has a 10% lead over the other candidates. Firearms groups across the country have declared this Sunday the first annual Gun Appreciation Day, so don't forget to set your clocks back 100 years. A new poll reveals that 56% of Americans believe Walmart is bad for the country, while the other 44% work there. The school board has decided to remove speech and debate programs from the course offerings this year. There was no argument. Graduates from last year's class are excited to be in the real world and have enjoyed their time since graduating. When reached for comment on what it's like after high school, one graduate said, "I find it interesting that my cologne rhymes with alone. Also, I can't afford cologne." Sad late news today out of Jackson High School, Mill Creek, where a devastating juggling accident has left one teacher armless. Doctors say he may never be able to speak Spanish again. A new study reveals 1 in 6 students feel comfortable taking tests, while the other 5 responded, "There was a test today?" A high school boy in Minneapolis was shocked when a girl texted him, "Come over, there's nobody home." When he arrived, no one was home. A new survey finds that 94% of Jackson High School males list Mrs. Elliott as their favorite teacher, while only 6% were able to answer the follow-up question, "What does she teach?" A recent survey on the top 10 most annoying things teachers do was published earlier this week. List at number 5, when you ask if you can go to the bathroom, they respond with, "I don't know, can you?" At number 1, not being Mrs. Elliott. The end of an era comes to Jackson as beloved English teacher Dan Geary announces his retirement. He says he'd like to spend more time with his family and that he must go. His planet needs him. Fascinating. Students prepare for the fun and pageantry of tomorrow's Tolo, where hundreds of young boys and men will have their spirits crushed as they realize out of literally thousands of girls at Jackson High School, none of them decided to ask me. On a related note, a big thank you goes out to Mr. Peters for volunteering his head to be the disco ball for tomorrow's dance. He okayed that one. I'm clean. I'm good. March Madness started today, which means, in other words, I'm already broke. I'm actually 3 for 3. I've got a perfect bracket, so. As the nation accepts equality movements, it can be reflected in many forms, like this year's yearbook, whose first all-male couple was awarded the senior superlative couple that should have been. We extend our congratulations, and I hope I pronounced these names correctly, to Michal Wholt and Benite Allen. We wish you a long and happy life together. And now we go to our freshman update to check in and see how they're doing. Freshman correspondent Robert Orlowski is live in the field with an exclusive report. Rob, what can you tell us about being a freshman?
Sucks!
Thanks, Robert. Always great reporting. Well, it's been 2 years since Jackson installed 2 sets of hand dryers in the Commons restrooms. The project has been deemed a triumph for the environment, and the person responsible has come forward with the idea as a revolutionary genius. When reached for comment, he said, "I'm just glad everyone likes them." It's been 2 years and still no turf fields at Jackson High School. Countless opportunities have been missed, and some are calling it the biggest failure to ever fail. We reached out several times for comment, which we were declined. Football coach Mr. Barashkov says, "Boy, I hate to be that guy." This just in, only about 10 people got those jokes. Also, I have no talent. Next at 11, where's Coney? Could he be hiding in the Jackson High School pool? I'll share my report. But for now, that's our time. Thank you for joining us. I look forward to seeing you right back here tomorrow night. I'm Zach Anders. You stay classy, Mill Creek. Good night.
Exception tonight. Normally I only perform this act at postmodern poetry slams, but I think you'll do this evening, so bear with me. This is probably a little over your head.
Thank you.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Ew, a talk show where we talk about really important issues. My name is Caitlin with a C and not a K, because K's are so ew. Now please welcome my friend, Ashley.
Ew.
Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
My favorite hobbies include shopping, ew. Dancing, ew. And watching Pretty Little Liars on Netflix. Ew. So, Ashley, how was your family trip to North Dakota?
Ew, it was totally boring.
Ew.
Yeah, there was no internet connection, so I couldn't post any of my selfies on Instagram.
Ew. You want to post one right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, is it on selfie? Oh, no, it's not. Whatever. Okay. Ew, okay, that's it. Ew.
So, I heard there's a men's pageant going on right now. Who do you think will win?
Definitely Tyler Whitman.
Ew! Really?
I think Ben Messner will win because he's super cute. Ew, whatever. He stands no chance.
Shut up. Let's not talk about this anymore, Caitlin.
Fine.
So, my parents have been getting all up in my grill about school. I hate it.
Parents are the worst.
I know, right?
Speaking of parents, is my stepdad, Darren.
How's it going, ladies?
Ew.
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to come play categories with your mom and I.
No, Darren, get out! Get out! Darren, get out! Get out, Darren!
All right, I'll catch you on the flippity flop.
Ew. He's such a sweat. Okay, now it's time to play a little game we call Ew Speedrun. Okay, you wanna start?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sea wave. Ew.
One Direction.
Ew. Bodybuilders.
Ew. Mr. Sabal.
Cute.
Really?
Yeah.
That's kinda weird, but whatever floats your boat.
Let's move on. Guys with super long hair.
Ew. Okay, last one. Guys that dress up in girls' clothing.
Ew!
That's so weird. That's so weird. All right, this has been Ew. Thank you for watching, and thank you, Ashley, for coming on.
Thank you.
Glad that's over.
Oh, man, I'm never doing that again.
What is one thing almost no one knows about you?
I used to be a ballerina.
Seriously,
like, I did ballet for like 2 years in like third and fourth grade.
What are your posts?
All dance getting tired. So you know. All dance getting nothing else, right?
What are your post high school plans?
I become a band teacher. I'm gonna become a band teacher.
That's pretty great.
Thank you, Max.
On to our next contestant.
Let's go, man.
If you were a Disney princess, who would you be?
If I were a Disney princess, I would definitely say I'd be Rapunzel because of my fantastic hair.
I dig the hair for it. Next question. What is the first thing you would do as president?
If I were president for a day, and now this is a serious issue, ladies and gentlemen, I would come back to Jackson High School and put coffee back in the vending machines. No longer shall we go these mornings tired. Who's with me? Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Jason.
Up next, we have Daniel Higgins Sanchez.
First of all, Mom, I love you. Dad, you're cool too.
Clearly a mama's boy. First question. What is the biggest global issue currently, and what are you going to do about it?
Ooh. Probably school lunches. You know, they're easy going down, but going out, that's not a story.
That's why I bring lunch.
Good idea.
If you could give one piece of advice to an incoming freshman, what would it be?
My freshman go here?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I guess I'd say keep doing what you're doing. I have no idea you go here.
Thank you, Daniel.
Thank you, guys. Mama, thank you.
Up next, we have Tanner Litchfield. First question, what is one thing almost no one knows about you?
I ate a slug when I was like 3.
How was it?
I don't remember much, but it was like dried up and it wasn't like, it didn't go down easy.
Sounds great.
That's in my past.
Who is your favorite teacher?
Anaya. Of course, Anaya. I had math with him. His mic doesn't work, but he said bonus points.
All right, thank you, Tanner.
Next we have Keenan Foster.
You okay?
I'm good.
First question.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Mr. Foster, Mrs. Foster.
Aww. First question. Who is your man crush Monday?
Mr. Nye.
No hesitation.
Can I ask why?
I did pretty well in his math class. Didn't I?
He said yes.
What is your best pickup line?
That's easy. Once you go black, you never go back.
Up next, we have Tyler Jones.
Love you guys too.
First question, what is your perfect date?
My perfect date would probably be August 13th because it's actually my birthday. And I don't know what other date you get presents on, so there you go.
Christmas.
And Halloween.
Halloween?
And Valentine's Day. Oh wait, never mind.
Okay, but I have no one. My birthday is when I get presents.
What is the first thing you would do as president?
As president, I would probably paint the White House beige so that I could call it the Beige House and lead this country in a more colorful direction. And I'm serious, so vote for me when I run. We could have a beige house, guys. Don't give up on that dream.
Jones versus Anders 2020?
Anders doesn't stand a chance as long as I've got beige paint in my garage. Thank you.
Zach Anders, you're next.
First question, who is your celebrity alter ego?
Thank you for asking me that.
You're welcome.
My celebrity alter ego would be Brian Williams.
Is there a reason why?
Thanks for asking.
What would you do for a Klondike bar?
Be honest. Honesty is the best policy. Future president?
I would lie about being a war hero on national television.
Thank you, Zach Anders.
Well, thank you, son, and I hope I have your vote.
Quite an entrance.
Alex Cheeseman, you are next. If you could give one piece of advice to an incoming freshman, what would it be?
My piece of advice for an incoming freshman would be just to make friends with Coach Nick. Just walk up behind him, give him a good tickle. It worked for me, so it'll probably work for you guys.
I tried that one time and it didn't go over too
long. Gotta catch him in a good mood.
Right, got it. I'll keep that in mind. Next question. What is your perfect date?
My perfect date? I'll take my girl to downtown Seattle, eat at a nice restaurant, Ferris wheel, maybe a nice romantic walk along the pier. What would make it perfect is she would pay for everything.
Awesome.
Thank you, Alex.
Stay away, Louise.
Next, we have Brian Betts.
Yeah, Brian!
Brian Betts, please do tell.
I will.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
Well, my biggest pet peeve is outie belly buttons. Because when you hug someone and you feel a poke right here, it just makes me uncomfortable.
Those are some pretty tight hugs.
My celebrity alter ego is probably Jack Black.
Can I ask why?
Like Paul Blart.
You can ask why, but I don't know why. So that's that.
All right, thank you, Brian Betts.
Thank you.
Next we have Isaiah Patrick. Who was your man crush Monday?
That's easy. B squared over there, because the way that he cuddles.
It's something.
Are you okay to answer the next question?
Yeah.
If you were a candy bar, what would you be and why?
If I was a candy bar, I would be a Klondike bar, because ladies do anything to get me.
Awesome.
Wow.
Thank you.
Next we have Peyton Shepherd.
First question. Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Well, that's an interesting question because over the last few minutes, that answer has changed.
Yes.
There's a certain teacher in here, I'm not going to say any names. I have her in the class.
Yes.
And I think we have this mutual respect for each other. Sometimes I do my work, sometimes she gives me a good grade. I thought that was how it worked. But she feels the need to make my struggles public.
Can I ask in what way?
Like saying it in front of all of Jackson. Or in front of the whole class. So Mr. Anaya, I've never had you, but you're my favorite teacher, that day.
If you were a candy bar, what would you be and why?
Well, if I were a candy bar, I'd be $100,000, because that's how much I'm worth, Lauren.
Well, thank you, baby. Next we have Mitchell Weaver.
I don't know how I follow that.
What is with the guys moving the stools?
We need to like make our own moment, you know? We can't use someone else's stool. I'm gonna stand. I'm actually gonna stand, so go for it.
What is your perfect date?
Oh, this is an easy one. I've thought long and hard about this. This is my, again, also my life work. I'm a simple man. It would start off in Seattle, a nice gala. Afterwards, we go to dinner, maybe stop for some coffee. There's a lot of good poetry places. And really, that's it. But I think the most important aspect of it is who it's with, and that's easy. It's my one true love, Bennett. Or Maddie, she's cool too. Yeah.
Next question. If you were locked in Jackson for a week, what would you do to survive?
I've also thought about this because it's actually happened twice. So I would stay in the D wing mostly because Crosby has Girl Scout cookies. And then I would climb in the attic above the C wing to get to the pool and just chill there and kill time for the rest of the week.
Is that where Cody is?
And where the pool's heated. heard the pool is heated. Is that true?
It is, yes. It's actually just one giant hot tub, Olympic size.
Bubbles?
No bubbles. That would be childish.
Great. Thank you, Mitchell.
Thank you.
And next we have Ben Metzler.
Would you like to...
Thanks, Mitchell.
Would you like... Oh, he's grabbing the stool.
Gotta sit.
First question. If you were a candy bar, what would you be and why?
If I were a candy bar, I'd be a Snickers because I satisfy.
What is your perfect date?
My perfect date... this is kind of like hot and cold, so... Sorry. My perfect date would be every day is perfect, just as long as I'm with Sabrina. So that's cute. Well, no, it's the truth, man.
Sabrina, you're lucky. Sabrina, you're lucky.
Ew.
PDA.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Yeah.
PDA off stage, please.
Bye.
Thank you, man.
Bye, man. Oh.
Tyler?
We have Tyler and
Tyler?
Tyler's friend.
Tyler? What's your mother's name?
Nash. His name's Nash.
Nash?
Hey, Nash.
Nash, you want to say hi?
Was he hi? You say hi?
Okay.
Nash. He's a little shy.
Nash, can you tell us what Tyler's perfect date would be?
What is it? He says that it is going to the gym, going to get some food, watching a movie, then going to sleep. But you have to, everybody's got to know that it's got to be with Amanda Crockett, of course.
Aww. Next.
Who is your celebrity alter ego?
Nash seems to think it's Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Because to him, I really am 6'3 and 250 pounds. So, I think we're close. And we got really big arms.
Yeah.
I mean,
I think he has bigger arms than you do.
Well, he's coming. He's coming close.
I think, how much does he bench?
Like 20. His whole body weight.
Awesome. Thank you, Tyler. Bye, Nash.
You want to say goodbye, Nash?
All right.
Round of applause.
Thank you.
All right. Let's hear a couple of final thoughts from our judges before we announce the winners. We'll start with Layla. Sorry.
I was very entertained.
That was 4 words.
That was great. Jenica?
You guys were really funny. You're all good. And I don't know what you thought of this. You're funny.
What?
I
can't hear you.
I said you were very funny, Tanner. There you go.
All right, Ms. Dandridge.
I think all 14 of you did a very great job, and I think it's really cute how you're all holding hands right now.
Last but not least, Ms. Vernaya.
Very entertaining. I enjoyed judging this. Felt awkward the entire evening. But otherwise, impressive young men here. Wish you the best.
We will announce our judges' winners. Can I get a drum roll, please? And the judge's choice goes to Tyler Jones! Congratulations! How do you feel?
Wow. That's so bad, so. Thanks, judges!
And we counted the votes. Drum roll, please. The winner of Mr. J.
JHS.
People's choice.
By people's choice is Mitchell Weehole.
Thank you. Give a hand to your contestants.
Goodbye.